Today, I'm going to show you how to do a quick dodge and burn effect on your images by automatically adding a dodge and burn effect. Hello YouTube, welcome back to my channel. My name is Erwin and this channel is all about photography and photo editing. If you're interested, please subscribe to my channel down below, hit that bell notification button and stay up to date when a new video comes out. Today I'm going to show you how to add a automated dodge and burn effect to your image. Normally for dodging and burning you will take a gray layer, set it to a blend mode of soft light and start dodging and burning the highlights and the shadows where you want them to really pop. There's also a quick way of doing this. This effect can be added by selecting the right filters and setting the right blend mode for that layer. So I will show you how to create this effect. And I will also give you a small trick on how you can do this really, really quick in under 30 seconds. In the end, it will only take you one press of a button. So for now, let's dive into Photoshop.
Before I explain to you how this dodge and burn effect works and how you can create it, I first want to point you to the card just up in the right corner where you can get my free preset pack. Just go over there, download the pack and have some fun in Lightroom. So now we're in Photoshop and we have this image of my friend Rachel here. And as you all can see, I got two layers right here on the right hand in the layers pen. One is the dodge and burn layer and the other one is the image. So if we disable this dodge and burn layer, we will see the effect of dodging and burning. So it will make the highlights pop and the shadows darker. This is what dodging and burning does for you. If you're a subscriber and you want to know how to do this completely automated, stick around to the end and I will tell you. For now, let's first disable this dodge and burn layer. Normally we would go the route by adding a new layer, filling this with a 50% gray, and setting the blend mode to soft light or overlay. And then we take the dodge and burn tool and start dodging and burning by hand to get the dodge and burn effect. I only did a small portion by hand just to show you how this normally goes. Now let's remove this layer and turn on the dodge and burn look. As you can see, the look is complete and it's all over. Everything is dodged and burned. This effect can be reached within 30 seconds and I will show you how to do this. Now, first let's get rid of the dodge and burn layer and duplicate our base image two times. This can be done over layer duplicate, enter and layer duplicate again, and now we have two copies of the base layer. Now follow along with these steps. Select the top image of the three and let's go over image, adjustments, inverse. The shortcut is Command I on Mac or Control I on Windows. Invert the layer. This might look a bit funky, but keep with me, stay with me. In the end, we will have a dodge and burn effect. I swear you. Now let's set the blend mode of this image to vivid light. And we're already getting somewhere on the grayscale. Still not what we want, so let's continue with the steps. We go to filter, blur, surface blur. And now we will see an image with more details. And this is what we want. For starters, the radius is set to 30, the threshold is set to 40. If you're getting further and further with this technique, you can start playing around with these numbers to get a better result for your image. For now, let's stick with the default values for this technique of 30 and 40 and hit OK. This takes a few seconds to apply to the image and we're done. Now we want to blend this great image with our base image, but we already used the blend mode and that's why I created a second copy. Now we need to merge the two upper layers to one. We do this by going to layer merge down, and we have one layer. Now there's still some kind of crazy color in the subject. We need to get rid of this so we have a pure gray layer with only black details. So we go over image, adjustments, and desaturate the image. Boom. Everything is black and white on a gray layer. Now this is a bit extreme, and if we zoom in, everything is very, 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 very detailed. And that's not what we want in this image. We want a Dutch and burn effect. We only want to make the highlights pop and the shadows a bit darker. To smoothen this out, we will use a blur, a Gaussian blur. And we can play around with the numbers here. We need to increase this where we can see what it is. See a bit of detail, but not too much. I will go with 15. So now apply the Gaussian blur. And now we can set the blend mode of this layer to soft light or to overlay, depending on the look you're looking for. Now to zoom in on the face and see what the difference is. Before, after, before, after. As I told you guys before, you can do this completely automated. Now to show you that this really works, I will remove this layer again. I will select the layer with the image. I will go into my actions, select my DMB base, action, and hit play. And now just wait. Now let's close up the actions tab. And as you can see, we have the gray layer set to blend mode overlay. And when I do a before and after, you will see the effect. Creating this action is very, very simple. Just remember all the steps we did before. But before starting, select your layer, go into the actions tab, and say create new action. Give your action a name and hit record. Then do all the steps we just did exactly as I showed them. And when you're finished with the last step, setting the blend mode from your last image to soft light or to overlay, hit the stop button over here. After that, you have created the action to create this nice looking Dutch and burn layer.
So this turned out to be a bit longer tutorial, since I also teach you how to create the action for automatically adding this effect. So now you can record this action. So now you know how to add a quick and dirty dodge and burn effect to your image and make those highlights and shadows really, really pop. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you do so, hit the bell notification button to stay up to date. And I will see you in my next video.